Shannon fam, welcome back to my channel. It is officially Shadow and Bone week. I cannot wait to fangirl with you all about this series in just a few days. But until then, here are 14 more behind the scenes facts about the Shadow and Bone series that you may not know. Author and executive producer Leah Bardugo knew Eric Heiser was the perfect showrunner because he was a fan first, saying he didn't hold this material in contempt because it came from the young adult literary space, which a lot of people do. Eric always approached the show with a sense of discovery and excitement as a fan of the material, and that means so much to me. Honestly, same, because we all had to sit through that Percy Jackson movie. It's been a lot of bad adaptations. Leah says when casting, lightning didn't just strike once, it kept striking, and they caught so much incredible electricity with this cast. When casting Alina, she was sent 5 audition tapes. The third one was Jesse. Leah actually stopped watching, called her producer, saying, "It better be Jesse because I'm not watching anybody else." When Leah visited set for the first time to meet the cast, Ben Barnes flew in specifically to surprise her. He snuck up on her and whispered his iconic line, "Fine, make me your villain." I mean, I would have just passed away right there. The cast grew very close while filming in Budapest. During their downtime, they would get dinner, sing songs, play the piano, have movie nights, and watch The Great British Bake Off in their PJs. I mean, we already know we love this cast. Author Leah Bardugo actually has a cameo in the series. Keep an eye out in episode 103 or you might miss her. After a scene with Alina in the little palace, Leah is the first Grisha to hug her. Leah chose to dress in a purple Durist fabricator kefta. Did you know Eric and Leah actually met through Twitter? Eric found his way to Leah's work through reading Six of Crows, which a friend described to him as Ocean's 11 via Charles Dickens in a fantasy setting. After finishing the book, he tweeted Leah thanking her for the story. He would go on to read all of her books as a fan. And a year later, her literary agent called and said Netflix bought the rights to Shadow and Bone. But Eric really wanted to adapt both Shadow and Bone and Six of Crows. A few months later, Netflix called again and said they bought the rights to everything. Showrunner Eric Heiser and director of photography David Lansenberg were both visually influenced by the 2015 film Macbeth. For Ravka, Lansenberg also drew inspiration from the 2017 movie Dunkirk, and for Ketterdam, the 2013 film The Grand Master. When Alina first uses her powers on the Shadowfold, costume designer Wendy Partridge designed an all-white version of her first army costume to help with the visual effects component in the scene. To create the Shadowfold, Lansenberg was visually inspired by the 2015 bog sequence in Mad Max's Fury Road, as well as the 2013 film Under the Skin. Visual effects supervisor Ted Ray, who also worked on Game of Thrones, wanted to keep the Vulcra design as grounded as possible. He was most visually inspired by demons and gargoyles. And for the Shadowfold design, he was inspired by the visual of Blackfyre, a gas explosion that never runs out of fuel, glows black instead of red, and reflects light instead of creating it. For the fight scenes, the actors worked closely with the fight coordinators on set, mainly training in a Russian form of martial art called sustima. I probably said that wrong, but. Costume designer Wendy Partridge was creatively inspired by graffiti, especially when designing the embroidery for Alina and the Darkling's keftas. And finally, Eric worked with David Peterson, the same linguist who created the Dothraki language for Game of Thrones, to create original languages for this series, including Ravkin, Kirch, Fjordan, and the sign language the crows use to communicate silently. And that is 14 behind-the-scenes facts about the Shadow and Bone series that you may not know. If you haven't already checked out part 1, which includes facts about the crows and costuming, make sure you do so, the link will be in the description box below. And give this video a thumbs up, comment, and let me know which scene you're most looking forward to seeing in the series. Happy Shadow and Bone week, guys!